And finally, the House of Representatives voted last week to temporarily suspend the nation's debt ceiling, delaying the fiscal battle for a few more months. You know, I was going to make a joke about this story, but I don't think it needs a joke. I think it needs to be slow jammed. You know what I'm talking about, Tariq?
Yeah, Jimmy. I think you're saying you'd like to slow jam this news.
That's right. I want to slow jam the news, and I'm not the only one.
Hello, I'm Brian Williams of NBC Nightly News and host of NBC's Rock Center, and I, too, would like to slow jam this news.
Hit me three times!
Less than a month after signing a fiscal cliff deal and narrowly averting a financial crisis, the Obama administration once again finds itself locking horns with Republicans over the issue of raising the debt ceiling, the amount of money the nation is legally allowed to borrow.
Oh, yeah. When it comes to raising the debt ceiling, the president's having a hard time getting it up. Seems the GOP ain't rubbing him the right way. Especially with the country $16.4 trillion in debt.
Say we're still in debt, but it's all right. The United States really couldn't get any broker. Gotta liquidate its assets just like Al Roker.
While most Republicans oppose raising the debt ceiling, several have voiced dissension within GOP ranks, and Democrats are now hoping this will pressure their House leader, John Boehner, and soften his hardline stance.
Take it from my man, Brilly Willie. Ain't nothing worse than a soft Boehner. Ain't nothing worse, especially when it starts leaning a little to the left. And it's gonna take more than a magic pill like the trillion-dollar coin to stimulate growth in the private sector.
All up in that sector. Zip. Our economy could really use a shot in the arm. It sounds like a job for Lance Armstrong.
Now, for his part, President Obama has repeatedly said he will not negotiate with Republicans over this issue, and he's made it clear he's willing to bypass Congress and increase the debt ceiling by executive order if necessary.
You ain't lying, honey, Bri-Bri. The president's got the bill in his hands. All it needs now is his John Hancock.
Whipping out his Hancock.
Obama's got Republicans in a compromising position, and now he's ready to push his package through Congress.
Push it. Push it good. Push it.
Push it real good. Obama's unwillingness to back down on this issue has left the GOP handcuffed, helped in no small way by the president's strong backing from prominent Democrats, including Senate Majority Leader Dick Durbin.
Hey, hold on. Hold on. You gonna roll up in here talking about handcuffs and dicks?
How was third grade, Jimmy?
50 Shades of Brian Williams!
Members of Congress have a big job to do.
It's time to come together and raise the roof.
Since the debt clock is rising, there ain't no denying the deadline for action is on the horizon. And partisan bickering is spreading like the flu.
And that is how we slow jam
the
news.
Oh, yeah.